There's new accessibility updates from Google. There's new information surfacing about the Vision Pro that's related to accessibility. Adobe now has automatic PDF tagging, new and improved apps, and so much more. Welcome to ANAT News for July 4th, 2023. Happy Independence Day to everybody, but let's dive into the news. First up is a new iPhone app called From Your Eyes. The way it works is a user can either take a photo or upload an image and it will send it to an AI, and the AI will send the user a draft of a visual description. If there's a problem with the description or it needs to be enhanced in some way, you can use one button to send it to a volunteer. That volunteer is supposed to look at the picture and look at the description and then improve it and then send it back to the user. I think we're all thinking the same thing. It sounds really similar to Be My Eyes. Next up is some new information about the Vision Pro. Some developers have been looking through all the information and have found something called visual search. And however it's invoked, it can identify objects, it can detect text, and then manipulate that text to use somewhere else. It can even translate, and it will come with 17 languages at launch. Really excited about the Vision Pro, and I will be talking all about it in a longer form video next week. Adobe recently came out with PDF Accessibility Auto Tag API, and this automates the tagging process. This API is powered by Sensei and will automatically be able to indicate the correct reading order for assistive technology users. This can save companies time, making PDFs readable for everybody. Microsoft Bing Chat is currently testing image recognition for a full launch sometime soon. About 10% of Bing Chat users now have access to the ability to upload images to Bing and then ask it questions about that image. A few users on Twitter have already been sharing their experience with it, from math equations to ancient pyramids. It'll be really interesting to have like an AI describe image feature on a screen reader. We'll see what happens. The Call Annie app, while it's not necessarily new, has gotten an upgrade with ChatGPT. The difference is it has voice output. It looks like you're in a video call with someone and you can speak to Annie, and she will speak back to you using ChatGPT. It's kind of cool and kind of creepy. A group of engineering students at Cal State Fullerton created a prototype for a pair of glasses designed to help visually impaired people detect nearby objects. The prototype uses smart technologies, including AI, machine learning, and voice recognition with a bone conduction speaker. Students will continue working on this project in the next academic year. Sounds pretty exciting. Let's see where it goes. And let's see how it'll be different from what we have now. If you haven't yet, June updates to JAWS and ZoopTex include a new message center for JAWS, improved auto detection of braille displays, and updates to ZoomText freeze view feature. Let's see when and how Freedom Scientific or Vispero adds AI to assistive technology. That's what I'm waiting for. NLS released Bard 2.0 for Android. This update includes increased app stability, bug fixes, and in-app search capabilities. This is part of a series of updates that NLS is planning to make it so that you do not have to go to the Bard website to search for books.
Thank goodness.
Google has some new accessibility updates for classrooms, but it could also be really helpful for everybody. You have the ability to generate AI questions for YouTube videos. There's a new tiled pairing feature for Google Meet. When this feature is enabled, it highlights both tiles when one of the participants speaks. This makes it easier to connect a sign language interpreter to a speaker. Google has a new image to text feature on Chrome on Chrome OS that will help screen reader users work with PDFs even when images don't have alt text descriptions. Google also announced that the reading mode feature, which is currently only available on Chrome OS, will be rolling out to all computers in the coming months. You can also enable reading modes in the Chrome flags. Currently, reading mode on the computer with the Chrome flags doesn't have the ability to read the text aloud, unlike the Android version. While we wait for this feature to come to Chrome, an alternative you can use is the Edge browser's immersive reader and read aloud, which honestly works pretty well and has great voices. VizLens and Image Explorer are two apps that are still a work in progress. With one of the apps, a user can point at a physical object and have the app read aloud what they're pointing at, similar to the new feature Apple announced called Point and Speak. And I mentioned that in the last ANAT episode. The other one you can use to explore an image that's on the screen. Seeing AI has a similar feature to this, but this has more AI.
It's all about the AI.
Those are your accessibility updates for this episode. Thank you so much for watching and listening, and I will catch you in the next one.